friends, users of the internet, my name is Stagertron, and I humbly welcome you back to another episode. Today, it's all about going fast, but we are not talking about Sonic the Hedgehog. Oh no, we're talking about racing games today. Now, ever since I can remember, I feel that racing games have held a near and dear place in my heart as one of my favorite genres, and I can always remember, even when I was a young kid, whether I was playing the latest arcade racer, the latest racing simulator, or even a simple car racer in the vein of Mario Kart. I always had a good time with them. So today what I bring to you is I've sort of compiled a top 10 list of what my favorite racing games are, and they're going to span all genres of racing. Now let me tell you this this wasn't the easiest list to make, but I think I've narrowed it down to 10 solid choices. So in advance, I apologize if your favorite game did make the list, but hopefully the games that you do see on this list surprise you, and you guys enjoy the video most of all. So without further ado, let's strap on those seatbelts, start our engines, and let's get to the game.
Auto Mona Lisa!
Now, the racing genre is something Capcom is not known for, but their first attempt at a racing game is definitely a solid effort. Mixing arcade and simulation, but leaning more towards the simulation side of things, with an emphasis on drifting akin to Ridge Racer, the game attempts to showcase Japanese racing culture and offers up some pretty hefty customization options to suit your driving styles. Visually, this game is so interesting, it offers up a very strong cel-shaded look, which has rarely, if ever, been seen in a racing game, and definitely offers up some visual flair. The soundtrack is decent, offering up a soundtrack that's suited for a racing-style game, offering very driving techno beats and rock style tunes with an announcer that sounds like he was ripped straight out of Street Fighter Alpha. The main mode at Auto Mona Lisa is Garage Life, where you can compete in various championships to unlock upgrades for your car, as well as options to actually customize your garage with various accessories. There's also an arcade mode, which doubles as essentially a single race, and the game also has a strong emphasis on online play, but has since been terminated, since we're talking about PS2 era game here. The one turnoff of the game for a lot of people is the handling. It's very stiff, and you may end up hitting the wall more often than not, no matter how many times you upgrade your car. It often feels like the car is just trying to fight you and combat you every time you want to turn. If you can get past that though, there is definitely a solid racing experience to be had here.
I'm looking forward to your next race!
Spinoff of Namco's long-running Ridge Racer series, R-Racing Evolution opts for the more simulation approach. One feature I do commend the game for is something you don't commonly see in a racing game, a story mode, which spans 14 chapters. Albeit not the strongest storyline, you play as Reyna, an ambulance driver turned race car driver and joining a racing team owned by a top secret corporation. There are various racing types such as circuit, drag, and rally races, although the regular circuit racing is definitely the strongest suit. One feature I really do like in this game is being able to put pressure on other drivers. While their meter flashes red, it'll cause other drivers to crack and mess up, often resulting in a spinout or them driving completely off the track. As you progress through the game's story and other game modes, you'll gain points which you can use to unlock multiple event challenges. And yes, there are a lot of them, especially since you can earn up to 3 stars on each one. You can also unlock various new vehicles which you can tweak and tune at your own leisure, and it's that easy accessibility that makes it feel more like an arcade racer as well. The graphics look decent as best, while not terrible, they do tend to hold up well. The soundtrack is okay, offering a handful of electronic style jams, but it's all completely original, which I do enjoy. And I do like the fact that the music actually plays during the races, as opposed to most racing sim games where you just hear the sounds of the cars. I really do hate when racing sims don't have music during the races. So if you're looking for a racing sim that's not as complex as, let's say, Gran Turismo, R-Racing Revolution will definitely fit in your collection.
That girl is good. Very good.
Star Wars Racer Revenge, the sequel to Star Wars Episode 1 Racer, takes place 8 years after the events of Phantom Menace. As the name implies, Sebulba is back to take revenge on Anakin Skywalker. Star Wars Racer Revenge is a futuristic battle racer with a good sense of speed, similar to games like F-Zero or Wipeout. There are three main game modes here: single race, which allows you to race on any track unlocked with any racer, versus race, which is of course the multiplayer modes, and it's classic couch co-op here, there is no online modes, and the meat of the game, the tournament mode. The tournament mode is split up across 13 tracks, which are divided up into 3 cups, where you can unlock additional racers and an art gallery. During the tournament, Wada will reward you with Truggets to allow you to upgrade your pod racer. This game also puts an emphasis on combat, as for every knockout, you'll be awarded an additional payout of Truggets. Now, tournament mode isn't exactly the longest gameplay, but the replay value here is added, as you can redo tournament mode with each of the 18 racers. The game has an excellent sense of speed, and the soundtrack has that epic Star Wars feel, but graphically, the game has not aged well, but that doesn't deter you from having an excellent gameplay experience. For what the game lacks in content, it makes up for with fast, smooth gameplay. The game was recently released on PSN for PS3 and will actually be updated with trophy support for PS4 and will be one of the downloadable classic Star Wars games included on the upcoming Darth Vader themed PS4. Burnout Dominator, in my eyes, seems like the underdog when it comes to the Burnout series, as I feel it doesn't get a lot of attention these days, but that's unfortunate because it's actually a great game. Developed exclusively for the PlayStation 2 and the PSP, it's actually the first Burnout game not to be developed by main series developers Criterion Games, despite the fact that they were given credit for it, as they were busy working on their Burnout magnum opus, Burnout Paradise. As with all entries in the series, the game has a huge emphasis on being fast and as reckless as possible. Throughout the course of the game, you'll progress through a world tour, split up into various car classes containing various race modes such as Race, Road Rages, Eliminators, Burning Laps, Maniac Mode, Grand Prix, Drift Challenge, Near Miss Challenge, and Burnout Challenge. Man, that's a lot of challenges. The main gameplay feature in this mode is burnouts, which is when you completely drain your boost meter without stopping, thus creating a burnout which can be chained into a combo for a point multiplier. There are 7 classes of cars that can be unlocked, and you can unlock various cars by completing various objectives during certain races, such as drifting a certain distance or performing a takedown on a rival car. As great as Burnout Dominator is, it does have its drawbacks. If you've been spoiled by Burnout Revenge, the traffic check doesn't exist, meaning when you collide with traffic, whether it's oncoming or you're following it, you will crash. Traffic attack mode, or the classic Crash mode, is absent as well, which is surprising since Crash mode has actually been a Burnout staple, which may shy some people away from this title. Burnout is a classic racing series, and Burnout Dominator is an excellent addition to the series, and here's to hoping that Burnout gets revisited soon, as a next-gen version would be a welcome addition. Sega returns with its arcade racing classic and sequel, OutRun 2, a game that's easy to play but difficult to master. OutRun 2's sense of speed is magnificent, with a very strong emphasis on drifting, as you race as fast as you can to reach each checkpoint. You can choose from 8 licensed Ferraris, of course some have to be unlocked during the course of the game, and you'll drive through various exotic locations such as a Summerside beach, desert, and alpine mountains. Each location, however, looking unique and offering up its own challenges along the way. You'll traverse about 15 stages with various branching routes that do range from easy to difficult, but if you don't master the roads that lay in front of you, even the easiest routes can pose a challenge. The game holds up really well. Even using the backwards compatibility on the Xbox 360, the graphics look bright and crisp. The soundtrack is also really good. While I mean it's kind of short, only holding about 7 tracks, they're all relaxing, they're all original, and they suit the tone of the game. Along with the original OutRun mode, there is a challenge mode boasting more than 101 challenges, with tons of unlockables, and there's a lot of content here to keep you coming back for more. But be warned, it's not easy. There's also an online mode, but of course, since the original Xbox does not support Xbox Live, there's nobody online. There's also an updated version of the game called OutRun 2006 Coast to Coast, which was released for the PlayStation 2 and the PlayStation Portable. There's also OutRun Arcade, which was released for the Xbox 360 and the PS3 as a downloadable title, but you can't even download the game or even play that version. Maybe one day Sega will resurrect the franchise on a next-gen console, but it does seem highly unlikely since Sega's Ferrari license has expired.
Game over!
And through the use of movie magic and the power of video editing, I do have a different shirt, and the background may look a little bit different. But congratulations, you've made it to the halfway point of this episode. We've talked about games 10 through 6, and feel free to start a discussion in the comments below. Is this what you expected from the list so far, or did you expect me to take it into a completely different direction? So going forward, you know we have games 1 through 5, so let's put our pedal to the metal, and without further ado, let's get to the games.
Split Second is a semi-futuristic arcade racer that is highly, highly destructive. The game makes you take part in a fictional TV show spanning 12 episodes, racing for money and glory. There are a variety of race events, including your typical race and eliminator style of events, as seen in games like Burnout, but there are also some unique gameplay modes like Airstrike, where you have to dodge missiles from an oncoming attack helicopter, or Survival, where you need to dodge various transport trucks that are trying to take you down with explosive barrels. The main gameplay feature of this game are what's called power plays, which are earned by causing destructing, drifting, doing stunts, or drafting. The power play meter is divided into 3 stages, which allow you to cause varying degrees of destruction. When you get into level 2 or maximum level, you can create shortcuts or even alter the track entirely, causing each lap to be dynamic and different. The production values are really high, and this game is really well made. The graphics are impressive. While not as bright and vibrant as some of the other games on this list, you feel very immersed in this bleak, destructive world. The soundtrack sounds very epic in scale, which makes it sound almost like a movie soundtrack. Did I mention there's a lot of explosions? Kind of feels like a Michael Bay movie on wheels, if it was a video game. Definitely a racing game worth checking out if you need a little destruction. I suppose I could have chosen any Mario Kart game for this list because they're all awesome, but today we're talking about Mario Kart DS. All the classic Mario Kart gameplay is here, and I'm really glad they went back to the single carts, as I was never really a fan of the double carts of Mario Kart Double Dash. It's the first Mario Kart game to include retro tracks, creating 8 cups with 32 tracks, as opposed to the usual 4 cups with 16 tracks. Mario and the gang are back, there's 8 main roster characters with a few unlockable ones. The classic game modes are here too, Grand Prix, which has you competing various cups with 3 degrees of difficulty, 50cc, 100cc, and 150cc. Of course, once those are all conquered, there is the fabled mirror mode. There's also a time trial mode, a versus mode, and the ever-loving battle mode is back with a new ability which allows you to try to reinflate your balloons to sort of give you a fighting chance. There's also a new mission mode included which has 7 levels, the 7th level being unlocked by getting a 1-star rank or better on each mission, and about 7 missions plus a boss battle in each. And the missions have you completing such tasks as driving through a set number of gates or collecting a certain number of coins. For a handheld game, this is impressive. It looks, feels, and sounds like Mario Kart should, and it has a plethora of content to keep you playing for a while. Sadly, the multiplayer on the game is no longer active, but if you don't have a physical copy of this game, you could also download it from the Wii U Virtual Console. The sequel to Excite Truck, ExciteBot's Trick Racing is a blazing fast arcade racer where you take control of various animal-themed robot vehicles, each with their own stats and abilities. ExciteBots will have you traverse 25 over-exaggerated courses spanning the globe from Canada, Egypt, and Finland, just to name a few locations, each with their own unique features. ExciteBots has many exciting features to keep you playing for hours. Excite Race, which is the main Grand Prix, Super Excite, which is a much more difficult version of Excite Race, Mirror Excite, which is of course the classic mirror mode. There is a Poker Race, which is a odd edition, but it'll appeal to fans of poker. I have no interest in it, but it's there, and there are a bunch of mini games. Excite Race and Super Excite are the main gameplay modes. Now, with any racing game, one wouldn't think that coming in first place is the main goal of any race to advance. In ExciteBots, this is not the case. The main goal is actually to collect stars by driving recklessly, driving fast, doing stunts, getting extreme air, and smashing into other racers, although placing well in a race will net you additional stars. So, as a rule of thumb, drive carelessly, but drive with precision. The number of stars you'll get will determine a ranking on the course, from S to D, S being the best and D being the worst. Of course, you could always replay these courses to get a better ranking, which leads to unlockables such as new vehicles. Throughout the races, you could also terraform the terrain, and the courses are huge, leading to multiple branching paths. And there are also little minigame segments such as bowling and soccer to keep the gameplay fresh. As I said, the game has an excellent sense of speed, and it runs very smooth with no slowdown. The game is definitely one of the stronger Wii titles when it comes to graphics, and it plays exceptionally well on the Wii U. From what I remember, this game used to have a very strong online community, but since the Wii doesn't have online support anymore, that community has since vanished. It'd be nice to see a new Excite title on the Wii U.
Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed.
The sequel to Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing, Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed, is an improvement in every way. At first glance, you may pass this off as a simple attempt to copy Diddy Kong Racing, but you'd be sadly mistaken. As the game implies, Transform does play a key role in the gameplay. Your vehicle transforms from kart, watercraft, and flying machine on the fly, meaning that you need to adapt to the dynamic race environments, which leads to some very innovative track designs. From characters, the soundtrack, the track designs, and the unlockables, this game is a love letter to Sega. This game looks some fantastic, supporting bright, vibrant, dynamic backdrops that let your eyes gaze in wonder at how beautiful and uniquely themed each track is after the various franchises throughout Sega's history. Sonic and all of his friends are here, with a few surprising additions like Wreck-It Ralph and real-life race car driver Danica Patrick. But in terms of characters, the PC version is the best version to have, as there are additional characters from Team Fortress 2, Company of Heroes 2, and the Total War series. This game has a lot of meat to it. Each character can be leveled up independently, unlocking various mods to suit different driving styles. Some players may find this game challenging, even on the easier difficulties, which is surprising for a kart racer. The soundtrack is really excellent too, offering up remixes of various classic Sega tunes, and this is a soundtrack I can easily listen to on my iPod or various other music playing devices, as they are upbeat and have lots of energy to it. There's a career mode consisting of a world tour mode, which is essentially the main campaign of the game, where players must compete in various challenges to unlock stars to progress through various branching paths to unlock various new characters and new tracks. There is also a Grand Prix mode, a time attack mode, and single race modes. Some may argue that Sonic never needs a car to go fast, but when he does, you're in for a real treat. Here's hoping to a next-gen sequel. F-Zero GX, in my eyes, the pinnacle of futuristic racing. F-Zero GX was the first significant collaboration between Nintendo and Sega. This game takes what made F-Zero X for the N64 awesome and expand on it greatly. The game boasts a roster of 30 characters, each with their own individual ship that each has their own stats, adding a layer of strategy when racing. And to see all the characters on screen at the same time at blazing speed is quite a feat in itself. The game has a lot of content to hold you over for hours. There's your Grand Prix mode, which is split amongst four cups: Ruby, Sapphire, Emerald, and Diamond. Possible Pokemon reference, maybe? Each one of these has four difficulty levels as well: Novice, Standard, Expert, and Master. These tracks are adrenaline-fueled, filled with twists, turns, narrow passages, big air jumps, cylinders, and corkscrews, and they are all quite magnificent to look at when going at blazing speed. The game is aged very well, with vibrant, futuristic visuals, and as I've said previously, the speed in this game is absolutely immaculate, and the soundtrack is fantastic as well. Adrenaline-fueled electronic remixes of classic F-Zero songs, as well as some new ones. The standard racing modes are all here, like your time trials, your versus battles, and your battle modes, but the meat of the game comes in the story mode, which, let's just say, is bone-crushingly difficult. It'll definitely put your pedal to the metal. I'm actually still unsuccessful in beating the story mode to this day. There's also a shop where you can use tickets earned from completing story missions or Grand Prix events to purchase other racers, customizable parts to build machines, and the one weird thing is to actually progress in the story, you need to buy the story missions from the shop, which is definitely a little weird. But despite having a difficult story, F-Zero GX is one racing game that I truly love. I love the F-Zero franchise since the beginning. It's definitely one of my favorite racing franchises, and I'm absolutely anxiously awaiting its triumphant return, because it's been about 10 years since we've had an F-Zero game.
Thanks for playing!
Alright, so before I wrap this video up, I just wanted to take the time to thank Channel Swifts for the shout-out that he gave me a couple of weeks ago. I think it's really awesome, and it's a real surreal feeling that somebody in a different country, on a different continent, no less, is, you know, taking the time to watch your content and, you know, take the time to appreciate it and share it with others. So I am definitely really grateful. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave a link to his channel either on the video or in the description, as well as the link to that shout-out video, because there's some other channels on there that he recommends checking out. And maybe you guys want to check them out too. So we're all here to support each other. We're a gaming community. So with that being said, guys, there it is. My top 10, you know, favorite racing games, or my top 10 definitive racing games across, you know, various consoles and different genres of racing. Hopefully it's the list that you were expecting. I had a lot of fun making this video despite, you know, its challenges, so I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, please leave a positive or negative comment down below in the comment section, as any constructive criticism does help me improve my content. So with that being said, guys, I will see you in the next video. Take care.